Praise the Lord. I'm very excited to be able to be speaking with you today and sharing the Word of God. I believe this is the best, beautiful, wonderful Sunday you're having in lockdown, wherever you are, all over the world. The psalmist said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually come out of my lips. I just want to thank God for all of you that have been following us up. I salute the Praise Cathedral fraternity. I salute everybody in the nation of Uganda that tunes in to watch these powerful, meaningful, and beautiful programs. And I thank our friends in Tanzania, our friends in Kenya, our friends in Burundi. Burundi, we salute you. Our friends also in the Congo, our friends in Botswana and Namibia, our friends also who are all over the world, of course, obviously in the US, Europe, Asia, you know, the Japan and Australia. Thank you very much for the feedback. Thank you for encouraging us. And thank you for being able, amen, to let us know that you're enjoying our services. May God richly bless you as you come under discovering and under this anointing. I just want to let you know the Lord will preserve you. The Lord will keep you. So today I want to share with you again, once again, from the book of Isaiah, Isaiah chapter 60. And I will be reading verse 1 and verse 2. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1 and verse 2. And this is what it says. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. For behold, darkness covers the whole earth, and gross darkness is upon the people. But the Lord shall rise up upon you, and his glory shall be seen upon you. I want to share with you, and I want to submit before you today using the subject arise, arise, arise. You don't tell somebody to arise who is already standing up. You don't tell somebody to arise who is already up there. You tell somebody to arise who has been downcast, who has been stressed out, stressed in, beaten up. Am I doing to somebody? You're lying down there. You don't know what the future holds. You don't know what's going to happen. And the Lord sends me to share with you today. And he says, tell my people, arise, shine. Oh, I wish I was with you in your living room, wherever you are right now. I'd be screaming at the top of my voice. Arise, shine. I would be saying, Godfrey, I will arise and I will shine. I will arise and I will shine. I know, you know, the lockdown can really be pretty much boring, pretty much bring a lot of uncertainty. You know, there are times when we would come back and you just sit in the couch and you sleep. But these days, I'm telling you, you go to your bed, you can't sleep. You come in the couch, you can't sleep. You try to sleep during the time, you can't sleep. You try to sleep at night, you can't sleep. And you say, excuse me, but I used to look for such an opportunity to sleep. I'm telling you, but something amazing is about to happen. Now, God tells the children of Israel, this is a prophetic word that is coming to you also, that arise and shine, for your light has come. So light can only be celebrated by people who are living in darkness. If you're not in darkness, you can't celebrate light. There are times when you can get a power outage. When the power outage, by power outage, I mean when the power goes, you know, and you get that power outage. When you get a power outage, something happens. You begin to say, now what do we do? You begin to look for other forms of light to light up your darkness. But when the light comes, woo, you celebrate. Why? Because darkness disappears as soon as light appears. As a matter of fact, the appearance of light is the disappearance of darkness. Now hear me, child of God, I want us to go deeper today. He says, for behold, darkness shall cover the earth and gross darkness upon the people. I'm telling you, darkness is all over the face of the earth. You go to Japan, they're in lockdown right now for 30 days. Gross darkness. Go to Korea, go to China, go to Malaysia, go to Indonesia, go to Australia, move all the way, come in the Middle East, come on, come to Africa, oh, move on to Europe, move on to the Americas, both North America and South America, go to the islands. There is gross darkness covering the whole earth. You know, As we were growing up, most of you, as we went to school, we studied about so many wars. The First World War, Second World War, we studied about the wars of the Napoleons, you know, all those other wars that were there before. But during that time, those wars would happen, but in specific regions, in different places. You understand what I mean? The intensity of those battles were limited to where they were. But now he says gross darkness covers the whole face of the earth. This pandemic has hit everybody. Baby to somebody living 120 years. It has hit somebody who, has, who is overweight, and somebody who is underweight, and somebody who has the right weight. I'm telling you, somebody who is poor and somebody is rich. Everybody is being affected. Everybody is under the cover of darkness. So what do? I come to give you hope. That in spite of that darkness being there, the Bible acknowledging that, the Word of God acknowledging that, he says in the middle of that darkness there's going to be a light. And that light is going to shine on you. You're going to become the light that everybody will look at and they will praise the Lord. So you're not going under, you're coming up. You will not be disadvantaged, you will be advantaged. You will not sink, you will float again. I wish, oh, you could shout hallelujah wherever you are. Now, I come here to declare and to decree to you that it is your time and season of preservation. It's a time and a season of being advantaged. It's a time and a season, amen, of sustention. You understand? God is going to sustain you. I want you to understand it's a time of conservation. God is going to conserve you as his remnant people. People that he has set aside for such a time as this. He will see you through. That's why he says in Isaiah 43, though you go through the fire, it shall not burn you, shall not consume you. Though you go through the waters, it shall not overwhelm you. For I am with you. Fear not! Are you with me, child of God? Hear me. So because of that, God will preserve you, will keep you, will sustain you. Now, we are facing extremely unprecedented times in our world today. Never such as has ever happened on the face of the earth. Never seen before in our generation. We might have studied it in history books, but in our time as we live, we've never encountered such a time as this. Do you know to lock up yourself in the house when there's no bullet that is, you know, coming up anywhere? Do you know what that means? Amen. Do you know what that means? Amen. To just be there. Hello, somebody. Being scared of an enemy that you don't know, you don't see. Being suspicious of everybody that you see. Not that they are going to kill you, but they carry something that is going to put you out. So never such a thing has it been happening in our human history. For those of you who are living, you and I. But I have some good news for you. During this shutdown, now, people have been asking me a lot of questions. No. And they say, is the world, you know, coming to an end right now? Is this the end of the world? No, this is not the end of the world. The world has not yet come to an end. But this is a precursor of things to come. And I'm about to share a little bit about that. Now, the world is shut down and people are hurrying and asking all kinds of questions. One of the questions they're asking me and asking themselves, is this the end of the world? And the big answer is no, no, no. But it's a precursor of things that are about to come. Now, if we see what are the signs of the end of the world, so we go to, when we go to our Bibles, we go to, let us go to 2 Timothy. Let's go to 2 Timothy. 2 Timothy. I hope you got it. When we go to 2 Timothy, I don't want to delay there, Lord. When we go to 2 Timothy, and we go to, yes, 2 Timothy. I got it. Yes, 2 Timothy chapter 3. I was just waiting for you. But okay, you can read. 2 Timothy chapter 3. Reading from verse 1, it says, this know also, that in the last days, perilous times shall come. That is difficult times, hard times, times that are inexplainable, times that are filled with challenges and pain and hurting. He says, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers. And I think you're seeing all this happening in our world today. They'll be disobedient to their parents, unthankful and unholy. You hear me? Without natural affection. I think you understand what that means. What is natural for them is going to be unnatural. They're going to have affection for unnatural things. And it goes on to say, what? They'll be truth breakers, I mean people who break peace, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good. When you're good, in these days they're going to despise you. They say you don't know what you're doing, you're just being foolish. You'll never be rich because you can't cheat, you can't, you understand what I mean? Having a form of goodness but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. Do you know we are living in our world today where people have a form of goodness but deny the power of God? They don't believe that God can talk to you, God can speak to you, God can help you. That is one of the biggest challenges. But I'm going somewhere. Oh, this is very interesting. He says, keep away from such people. And he says, amen, verse 7, ever learning and never being able to come to the knowledge of truth. They learn, but they never express what they have learned. Now, there is a, okay. He says in verse 11 that we're going to face persecutions, afflictions, which will come. Amen. And so now, having read that, I want us to go a little bit further. He goes on to, people have been asking me questions. Where is God in all this? Let me tell you, God is still there, seated on his throne. God is still where you left him. The world departed from God, and the world is doing their things. And they say, where is God in all this? God is still where he is, and he gave us his address and how to get to him. So God and is going to be the chief actor, amen, if we are going to have a way of coming out. This light that is going to shine, amen, is God who is going to shine the light and will come out of this confusion and out of this chaos. Amen. God is good all the time. Now, hear me, child of God. It is so unprecedented, you know. I mean, it's something new. You know, when you see schools being shut down, and they are shut down not because they are holidays. When you see, amen, when you see many things like our schools being shut down, our places of work being shut down, our shops being shut down, our stores being shut down, our malls where we used to go shopping. People love shopping so much. I salute all the ladies and the men. They are shut down. The sports stadiums, people who love sports, they are shut down. Oh, those who like eating out, different restaurants, they are shut down. Those who like, amen, hallelujah, going clubbing, it is shut down. Even those who enjoy drinking, they can't go drinking in those places where they enjoy drinking, it is shut down. Oh my Lord, looks like the whole life is shut down. But hear me, child of God, God is good, amen, because man has been trusting in themselves. Oh, but are we about, amen, to begin to see the grace of God move like never before? We've trusted in ourselves, but we are failing. We are failing. I'm telling you, when you see what is happening in the world, you see failure. When you look at what is happening in the major cities of the world, you look at what's happening in New York, you look at what is happening in New Orleans, in Michigan, in Chicago, you look at what is happening in Italy, you look at what is happening in London, you look at what is happening, amen, amen, I mean in China itself, obviously, you see that what is happening in Tokyo, you see that what is happening all over the world, and you say, Lord, what is happening? Man has advanced in everything, but cannot deal with this simple virus that is manifesting with flu and cough, you know? But hear me, child of God. Hear me, child of God. It's not simple because it can't be handled. So in other words, much as it looks simple, it's not simple. But the light of God is going to shine and we will overcome this. Hear me, child of God. Now, the scientific researchers of this world are being challenged. The financial institutions of this world are being overwhelmed. Because, I mean, they don't know what to do. Nobody has an answer. Nobody has a solution. But hear me, amen. Even churches have been shut down. People didn't like to go to churches, but they are now shut down. There are those who went into churches, amen, and never cared about reaching out to the whole world. People were not, they were more interested about the corners of their church, and they can't enter into the churches. So I want you to understand, why is all this happening? And God, I want you to understand, is at the center of it. He's watching, and he's going to take church. Are you with me? He's going to take church. Now, before I conclude, amen, I want you to know that Jesus said in John chapter 14, verse 6, he said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life, and no man comes to the Father except through me. Jesus said he is the address, he is the highway to the Father, he is the expressway to the Father. And he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. We cannot keep Jesus out of what is happening now. We need Jesus to be at the center of whatever is happening. And those of you who are watching me right now, I challenge you to receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You need to know Jesus for yourself. Forget about the Jesus that your father knew, the Jesus that your mother knew, the Jesus that your uncles talked about. You need to know the Jesus for yourself. You need to receive him. He's the only way. He's the only truth. He's the only life. Now, hear me, child of God. He is the way. In other words, he's going to make a way out of this darkness. He's going to make a way, amen, that will cause you to rise and shine again. Hear me, child of God. I want to share with you a scripture before I close. It is a scripture that we can find, amen, in Daniel chapter 3. Daniel chapter 3, this is what is going to show you that God is going to preserve you, God is going to give you sustention, and God is going to give you conversion. God is going to sustain you, keep you, amen. Hello, are you there with me? God will sustain you, he will keep you, he will uphold you, and your life shall never be the same again. Let me just strengthen myself a little bit, amen. You know, whew, God is good. Now, hear me, child of God, hear me very well. God is amazing God. Now, when we go into Daniel chapter 3, I want to show you something, that this crisis has happened in the Bible times before. You remember in the days of, who is this man? You remember in the days, amen, of Moses, God used him to preserve the nation of Israel and draw it out of the land of bondage in Egypt. This same thing happened again. It happened in the days of Noah, when the whole world went rebellious. And when judgment came, you remember, God delivered this man by the names of Noah and his family and all the animals of the world. God preserved. No, this is exactly what is happening. Do you see that the animals are being preserved right now? The animals are enjoying their life. Life is moving on. That's what happened. God is preserving them. Preservation. He preserved the animals, but also preserved Noah and his family. In the same way, God is going to, he's showing us evidently that he's preserving all the animals, all the plants, and then that is evidence that God is going to preserve you too, because you're valuable. You carry the blood of Jesus. You carry his name. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, when we move on to Daniel chapter 3, reading from the New International Version. Daniel chapter 3, I think in verse 26, that's what I want to share with you. Verse 26, it says, then Nebuchadnezzar approached the opening of the blazing furnace and shouted, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, servants of the Most High God, come out and come here. So Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came out of the fire, and the satraps, prefects, governors, and royal advisors crowded around them. They saw that the fire had not harmed them, and it had not harmed their bodies, nor was a hair of their heads singed, in other words, burnt. Their robes were not scorched, and there was no smell of fire on them. This is what we call preservation. Conservation. God preserves his remnants. That's exactly what is going to happen to you. Hello? We're going to come out of this COVID fire, and you come out dancing, you come out celebrating, you come out jubilating, you come out dancing, hallelujah, because God is going to draw you out. He's going to dance with you in this fire, in this lockdown, hallelujah. I feel excited as I'm sharing with you today that God is about to show up for you. He will not leave you alone. He treasures you. He loves you. He gave his only son, Jesus Christ, to die for you, because he treasures you so much. He loves you so much that will not just let you go just like that. You hear me? Now somebody might say, but we've seen people who believe in Jesus who have died. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing the word of God. I'm giving you the faith that God is going to preserve you. Do you hear me? He says the just shall be. The just shall be what? Amen. Shall receive, amen. The just shall be justified by faith. So it is your faith that's going to justify you, that's going to help you, that's going to sustain you. Now hear me, child of God. Then Nebuchadnezzar saying, praise be to the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. After we come out of this, people are going to praise your God. They will praise your God. He said, oh, him who sent his angel and rescued his servants God is going to send an angel to rescue you, to rescue your family, to rescue your children, wherever they are, in any part of the world. God has already commissioned angels to rescue your children and help them and deliver them. I have good news for you that you will be sustained. Arise and shine in the mighty name of Jesus. I feel excited. I feel you're getting excited too, because you will make it in the name of Jesus. You know, God has proven a God who sustains, a God who conserves, a God who preserves, a God who sustains his people. As I've told you, you remember when Sodom and Gomorrah were burning, what did God do? God delivered, who is this man? He delivered Lot and his wife and his two daughters out. He drew them out. What does that show? That God is so much concerned about you that he's not going to let you burn in there. He's going to release his hand and he's going to draw you out. Now, hear me, child of God, that was a typology or a quintessential, amen, juxtaposition of God's delivering hand, and it was a quintessential juxtaposition of the rapture. That's what exactly God is going to do. He's going to reach out his hand and deliver his children, and he will draw you out. I want to conclude by saying, you will be preserved, you will be advantaged, you will be sustained, you will be conserved, you're God's remnant. Before I pray with you right now, I want to encourage you, amen, if you've been enjoying, amen, these messages, that God will richly bless you. You can send in your seed or your offering or your tithe through World Remit, if you're out of the country of Uganda, or you could send it, amen, amen, on the following phone numbers, MTN number, which is 0772593828. I repeat, 0772593828. Or if you're sending it via Airtel, and if you have a red number, you send it to 0702593828. I repeat, 0702593828. Now I'm going to pray for your offering or your sacrifice or your seed or your vow, whatever it is, whatever financial donation that you want to send, that God will bless you and preserve you in this season. I'm going to pray with you now as you get ready to do that. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I just want to thank you. In this difficult time, your children are rising up, Lord God, like it was in the days of Elijah, when King of Glory, that lady in Zarephath, provided her little meal that she had and gave it to Elijah to eat it up. My Father, you looked inhuman in the eyes of people. But Lord God, that is the way you work. You work in an amazing way, and you provided supernaturally that she never lacked a single day. My Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray, King of Glory, as they offer this, let it be as it was in the days of Elisha, that the woman that continued to give and continued to sustain them, King of Glory, you blessed her with a child in old age. Even when the child was dead, you caused the child to rise up back to life. Father, you said, blessed is to give than to receive. Blessed it is, O Lord God, O Father. I pray for the blessings, O Lord God, O Father, that you decreed and declared in Deuteronomy chapter 1, 1,000-fold increase, that you shall increase them 1,000-fold in the name of Jesus. In this difficult time, that, Lord, they will lack nothing good. As they submit under this anointing, Father, as they give you to this anointing, I pray, King of Glory, that you sustain them in the name of Jesus. There are those that are working, but there are those that are not working at all, Lord. They are seated, they don't know what to do. They are running out of supplies, my Father. I ask you in the name of Jesus, show up. Appear by fire. Appear by fire. Let there be miracle provision. All this, Lord, I've prayed with thanksgiving in Jesus Christ's holy name. And somebody says, amen and amen. Oh, I know you have enjoyed these programs. I'm right now going to pray with you and bless you, that the Lord will preserve you, because there are those sincerely who are still working, and there are those who are prospering in this season. That is for a fact. But again, at the same time, there are those that are going under in this season, and there are those that are just in between, just floating in there. But I want to pray with you right now, The same God who says, arise and shine. He says, he identifies, he sees that there is darkness all over the earth. But he says his light is going to shine upon you. I'm going to pray for the light of God. Remember, his marvelous light, amen, deals with every kind of demonic activity and destroys it, amen. It's his light shall shine upon you, upon your family, upon your children, and upon your investments, and you will be preserved. Are you ready for this prayer? I want you to stretch your hands towards your phone or towards your screen if you're connected to the television screen or your computer or your iPad or your tablet. Whatever medium you're using, amen, I want you to stretch your hand and this power that I feel is going to go through you. Now, at this moment, everybody is just talking of one kind of sickness that is nothing other than corona and COVID-19. But all other sicknesses that were there before are still there. People are having ailments. As I pray for you, whatever ailment you're experiencing, the healing hand of God is going to move. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for healing. I pray for deliverance. I pray that, O Lord God, O Father, you sustain your children. In the name of Jesus, King of glory, I pray that you sustain them, that you preserve them, that as you sent an angel and you drew Sadrach, Meshach, and Abednego out of the fire, as you deliver the children of Israel out of the hand of the Egyptians, as you deliver King of glory. And preserve, oh Lord God, Noah in the days, oh Lord God, when the whole earth was submerged under flood, and you preserved even those animals. King of glory, we've already seen your hand preserving animals and preserving the plants. We pray right now, Lord God, that you preserve, oh Lord God, your chosen ones, your loved ones, that you preserve the human race once again in the name of Jesus from extinction. Father, I remember you promised, King of glory, when Noah came out of the ark and offered that sacrifice, you told Noah that never again will I destroy this earth. Father, we thank you because you watch over your word and your word shall not come to null and void. Father God, oh Father, heaven and earth shall pass away, but your word shall endure forever. And you said you will preserve, never again will you destroy this world again. Father, I know you will not destroy this world. Father, I know you will preserve us. We pray that every satanic agenda that, oh Lord God, is trying to override your agenda will boomerang right now in the name of Jesus, that it will not succeed, it will not prevail. My Father, in the name of Jesus, let there be healing. I pray miracle healing, oh Lord God, oh Father, for those that already are under this sickness and disease, oh Lord God, oh Father, the COVID-19 and corona disease. Father, I thank you for those that you've been healing, King of glory, those that we've been praying for and you've been healing them, oh Lord God, all over the world. I thank you and I honor your holy name. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will heal right now, that you will heal right now, that you heal those that are having different kinds of ailments, oh Lord God, bone problem, oh Lord God, kidney problems, eye problems, problems, ear problems, back problems. Father, heal them from rheumatism, from rheumatoid arthritis, from arthritis, from, oh Lord God, oh Father, all kind of juvenile arthritis. Heal them, my Father, pray in the name of Jesus, from asthma and related, oh Lord God, oh Father, breathing problems, respiratory difficulties. I pray, King of glory, that you deliver your children from high blood pressure, from diabetes, diabetes 1, diabetes 2, and all kinds of other kinds of diabetes, that you deliver them and heal them with your mighty hand. In the name of Jesus, Father, I'm praying for them and I thank you because you've healed them. Father, right now I pronounce that your light shall shine upon them, that they'll be preserved by your light. Preserve them, my Father. Preserve them, my God, I pray. All these are decreed and declared in Jesus Christ's holy name. And somebody says, amen. I love you. Thank you for tuning in. Don't miss our Thursday programs. They are powerful and amazing. And as we will be going deeper, you know, I want to be able to teach you these things so that you get to know these things from the Bible and exactly what is happening. Nothing is new, nothing is surprising God, because everything is according to the script. Amen. It's a script that's already written. It's a prophecy that was already pronounced, amen, in the days of Ezekiel, in the days of Daniel, already pronounced in Jeremiah, parts of Isaiah, pronounced in the book of Revelation, decreed and declared by Jesus in Matthew 24. So these are things we'll share with you, and I believe God will bless you. You are lovely people. We love you. We miss you. We are looking forward to that time when we will meet. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, I thank God. Amen. Of course, we are social distancing right now. And keep social distancing. Keep washing your hands. Keep taking care of yourself. Follow all the government regulations that they are telling you wherever you are, in whichever country you are, and you will be kept, you will be preserved. The blood of Jesus is upon you. We pronounce and plead the blood of Jesus over you. You will survive. Fear not, for the Lord thy God is with thee. We love you and we say, mwah. God bless you. Bye-bye.